The games people have a definite constraint, like if it goes less than 30 frames per second, then they have to cut back somehow. They have to get rid of polygons, or they have to go beat their artists to put, you know, less content in the scene. But since you're selling to who knows who, you know, the guy could say, well, I want 50 oil derricks or, you know, 50 whatevers, you know, in my scene. And so what kind of techniques are used to sort of control that, you know, well, I want as much as I want, you know?
Some of those are sort of reducing geometric complexity, where if you have a complex model, so as you're starting to orbit around, if it's too slow, we can decimate some triangles from that. So again, there are a lot of techniques that are similar between games and CAD in those situations. We tend to let the user have more control over that, where, again, they may care more about it. Some customers may be fine, you know, if they need to orbit something, we can turn it into a wireframe object, because that will get them to the point they need, and then we go back to the full resolution. And lighting is another one where we can have some effect. We can have a landscape lighter who has 1,000 lights in their scene. And you can't necessarily do that in real time. So sometimes we'll cut out some of the lights that will have a lesser effect on the scene. So instead of getting 100% fidelity with the real world, we may only look 80% correct while they're moving around. But then once they stop, then we can go back to showing the full scene. Uh-huh.